Good morning. Let's measure how helmets affect impulse and impact force.
Flippin' physics.
Nice 70s clothes, everybody.
70s day.
Sadly, I'm actually not willing to slam my head into a force sensor.
Makes sense.
Yeah, okay.
Therefore, modeling a human head today is this medicine ball, which has a mass of 2.733 kilograms. Class, is the medicine ball wearing a helmet?
Nope. No.
No helmet on that medicine ball.
I dropped the medicine ball, which is currently not wearing a helmet, from a height of 39.5 centimeters, and it lands on a force platform. The force as a function of time looks like this. The maximum force of impact was 1,310 newtons. The average force of impact was 618 newtons. The time during the collision is 0.015 seconds, and the impulse, or the area under the curve, is 9.84 newton seconds. Again, this is all information while not wearing a helmet. Bo, remind me, what is the equation for impulse?
Net force equals change in momentum over change in time, where both force and momentum are vectors.
That's Newton's second law.
Yeah. Okay, multiply both sides by change in time, and you get impulse equals change in momentum, which equals net force, which is the force of impact during the collision, times change in time.
Remember, impulse is a vector, and impulse is the area under the curve.
And we often replace the net force, or the force of impact, with the average force of impact.
Yeah, I remember all that.
And Billy, how does adding a helmet to somebody's head during a collision affect all of the variables in this equation?
Adding a helmet increases the distance a human head has to slow down, and therefore it increases the time during the collision. However, it does not change the initial velocity, or final velocity, or mass of your head. Therefore, the change in momentum, or impulse, should stay the same. Therefore, the net force, or the force of impact during the collision, is decreased because the change in time is increased. Yeah, that's how it works.
Thank you, Billy. Now let's give the medicine ball a helmet.
Wait a second. I think that's a cloth diaper, not a helmet.
That's true, but I actually could not find a helmet which fit this medicine ball, and putting a cloth diaper on the force platform serves the same purpose. It increases the distance during the collision, and therefore increases the change in time during the collision. Now, when I drop the same medicine ball from the same height, only this time with the helmet, this is the graph of impact force as a function of time acting on the helmeted medicine ball. The maximum force of impact was 971 newtons. The average force of impact was 544 newtons. The time during the collision is 0.018 seconds, and the impulse, or the area under the curve, is 10.3 newton seconds. Notice how the change in time during the collision is increased, the average force of impact is decreased, and the maximum force of impact is decreased. However, the impulse was actually slightly increased because of the diaper. If you watch the video closely, you can see that the rebound height with the helmet is actually a little bit higher. This means the velocity after the collision is a bit larger, which confirms the fact that the impulse was actually increased slightly. Now, this did surprise me a bit, but the helmet still increased the change in time during the collision and decreased both the maximum force and average force experienced by your head. Thank you very much for learning with me today. I enjoyed learning with you.
Bo? Is that a dress?
It is a dress. And I look good in it.